Hey, this is Chris Menard. I'm in Microsoft Teams. I'm running Copilot. I'm late for a meeting, about to join it. I have the meeting pulled up. I can tell from the camera that it's being recorded. There's the record icon also. I have Copilot icon up in the top right. What Copilot will do in a Teams meeting that's being recorded is allow you to get a summary of what you've missed if you come in late, like I'm going to do. It'll also do a summary or a recap at the end of the meeting, and it is a great feature. I've always joined the meeting to get the recap, but if I click Copilot right now, let's see what it does. Get info from the chat, try out all the prompts, it's your Copilot. There you go, at the bottom it says recap the meeting. I'm gonna go ahead and pop in though the meeting and do it, so I'm gonna hit join. Hey, good morning. So I have up at the top menu in the right, by the way, I didn't mean to interrupt your conversation, up in the top where y'all have mic and camera and all that, I have a Copilot icon. I'm going to click on Copilot. Copilot pulls up and has given me some prompts, but I'm going to type in recap what I missed from the start. And then I'm going to throw it in the chat and y'all can tell me if it's correct. In case anyone's wondering that's going to view this video, this Copilot is only for me, so no one else is seeing what I'm doing, which is cool because that would be pretty bad. It is generating a response. All right, I'm going to copy this and I'm going to put this in the chat. All right, that's what it says.
Okay, here we go. So we discussed the progress of the videos for the course, correct? And Deanna designed the thumbnails, she set up the chapters, uploaded the files and the videos. And then I asked about the individual course thumbnails, correct? And then we mentioned that I need to redesign that page that you just shared with me a few days ago. And she's also going to work on transcripts and uploading the course lessons for Excel. And then there's one thing we discussed that was not included, apparently. It's the fact that you can upload a video on Thinkific on the course platform and include that video on more than one course. Okay. I do not see that. It does say that some of the videos are overlapping with the Excel and Teams courses, which is correct. But we also mentioned that a to-do point would be to add the missing videos to the Excel course, the ones that are Copilot. And to not upload those videos again, just use the ones we already uploaded. So that point, which is quite important from my point of view to this discussion, to avoid duplicate videos, but it was not picked up, apparently. Well,
so it's not 100%, but it is pretty good, right?
It's very good. It's very good. I suppose it can't really give you all the details. If you want to get all the details, you read the transcript or watch the report.
Correct. So I asked it that question, by the way, because you can ask it questions during the meeting. And I said, can you upload more than one video? And it came back with that answer.
Correct. That is correct. Yes. But okay. That little point was...
But it was missing from the summary. Still liking it.
Yeah, it's great. So, I mean, it's cool if it catches you up. As soon as you join, that's fine. And I wanted to ask, does it also do a summary of everything that was discussed and action points at the end of the meeting? Can you do that?
So yeah, if I hit Copilot, it says recap the meeting so far, list action items, suggest follow-up questions. I'm going to type in any action items so far.
Or maybe you can ask, what does Christy need to do? What does Deanna need to do to see if it knows whose action items are? Maybe that would be even better.
Okay. So here's what I got from the back to chat.
Okay. Deanna will upload thumbnails. Yes. I will review that page. She'll do the transcripts, upload the lessons in the course, finalize some of the videos. We'll finalize the one save workaround. Correct. That is all of them.
Amazing though, isn't it then? That's cool then. Okay, good. Let me do one more Copilot. I'm going to go to Copilot. I know the meeting's not over, but I'm going to go summarize the meeting. I also like that it's cool that if I've got a Copilot license, I can use it. Do you know what I'm saying? Not everyone has to have the Copilot license. All right, so here's the summary. Oh, by the way, after I did the summarize the meeting, it actually is prompting me to list action items again, which is kind of cool. Okay, so here's what I get.
If you pay for Copilot, you have it on your account. Does that mean that it's available to you even when you join a meeting that's not been created by you, doesn't own you?
As long as the person that created the meeting is in our tenant. So if either one of you created the meeting, I can use it. Now, if somebody outside of Chris Menard training makes a meeting, my Copilot's not going to work for their meetings, which is kind of good. Yes.